Hello everyone, and in this video we'll be having another look at the Brave browser on the Fire tablet. We did have a look at Brave browser, I think it was last year actually, but the reason why we're looking at it again is we're testing it for Dolby Atmos compatibility on Fire tablets, but again we'll clear that up in the video. But this is fairly important to Fire tablet owners, so please subscribe to the channel because we will be testing many more browsers to come. And if you want to catch up on previous browser tests, then feel free to browse my channel. So again, please subscribe and we'll get started. We also have a surprise at the end of the video, but again we will explain that later on. Now the Brave Privacy Browser offers very good privacy technology, which includes privacy shields, and you may have seen it advertised on YouTube, which therefore tells us that it is a fairly popular browser. So it says, welcome to Brave Browser.
Search engine onboarding, Brave Shield.
Search engine onboarding, Brave Shield. So it's obviously like a tutorial.
DuckDuckGo, DuckDuckGo Lite, RadioQuad.
And you can choose your search engine
radio button, zipped.
Before you can get started.
Search engine, start page, radio button, search engine not next.
And I think
search engine on next button.
You can actually decide whether it has a start page or not before you actually get started.
Next button. Turn on button. 16% Brave Rewards.
Now
Brave Rewards. Brave. Start browsing button.
There is a lot to this tutorial.
Brave Rewards is not available on your device. Okay, back. We're so back.
Which is a little bit of a humbug really, because as you see I clicked the next button and I had to click it again just to move on. But again, you know, that is that. So you got 000 add block of track, add tracker blocked, and which therefore tells us the number zeros represent how many things have been blocked and how many, you know, whatever has been blocked.
Amazon.com.
You got Amazon.com.
Wikipedia.
But that 000s sort of gets in the way when you are scrolling for social media, for your desired social media feed. Another thing which we've noticed is we haven't got a article section, which couldn't be more critical now because of the coronavirus, as you probably know. So again, that's something that needs to be looked at or changed. The more options is in the top right hand corner, which is really good, and the more options is the browser menu, and as you probably know, we looked at browsers where the menu is at the bottom. And again, if you are a Fire tablet owner like myself, or if you have bought a new tablet or a phone, these devices are not coming with home buttons anymore, which I personally, you know, I like a home button. But the reason why we say that is you could accidentally click on the home screen when you want to click on the menu. So again, that can be really annoying. So you got new tab, new private tab, bookmarks, recent tabs, along with your download. You got turn on request desktop site, which requests a desktop view on your mobile device, and it can change the website behavior as well, which is fairly useful in rare situations where you want to add a YouTube card to your YouTube videos on a mobile device.
Set as default
You got set as default. Exit, 10 of 10. And an exit button.
Settings.
Which is handy also.
Standard tab, search engine.
So you got search engine, standard tab. Oh, okay, standard tab, start page.
Private tab, start page, basics, heading.
And you got basics.
Five of 24 payment methods, passwords.
Passwords.
Payment method, addressed home page. Welcome.
And you got home page.
Eight of 20, welcome tour.
And you got a welcome tour.
Appearance, display, heading.
Display appearance.
Controls,
and you got that
background video playback,
which is
background video play, closing all
tabs, which is fairly handy because you don't really see that fairly often. As you know, one thing we like to look at is the accessibility section.
You
got text scaling, force enable zoom, simplified view, open tabs in custom tabs,
simplified view captions 6 of 6,
simplified view for
simplified view for open tabs,
for open tabs. And it got captions, which is what we've seen on Chrome. We do see a caption section, which is fairly good. Now, one thing that we haven't seen on this, and which a lot of browsers lack, is a night mode, which is supposed to filter out certain colors, which can hinder the sleep hormone melatonin production. So again, that is why they advise you not to watch TV or look at your tablet before, you know, you go to bed. And again, if your device does not have a night mode, such as my Galaxy Tab A 9.7, then having a night mode in the browser is fairly useful. However, if your device does have a night mode, I will suggest turning both on. So that is that. Now, about in regard to this Dolby Atmos thing, you will probably notice that when you play a video in your web browser, as opposed to the dedicated app, you don't get that Dolby sound coming from your speakers. Which is why we're testing browsers again to see whether they are compatible with the Dolby Atmos. Now, usually, lately, we have been playing videos on Quest OD. But I'm going to play a YouTube video for a change, even though this browser has a built-in video player, which should be capable of playing Quest OD. But again, for today, we'll be playing a YouTube video. Now we'll give this video a listen.
Search. K button. Screen curtain. Screen curtain disabled.
Sorry about that. We'll just turn the speech off and we'll turn the volume up and give this video a listen. Now, as you can probably see, I've had to turn the volume up quite a bit just to get an equivalent volume. And as you might have seen, this video is of a Mazda RX-8 startup and engine rev, which in itself should provide plenty of bass for the speakers. And although you can hear the engine rev, I've had to turn the volume up. I'm not too sure how it's coming across on this screen recorder, but it isn't as bassy as it should be, which therefore tells us that it is not Dolby Atmos compatible. Okay. Now, as you probably saw lately, we had reviewed UC Browser and UC Mini, and we were wanting to test video playback for Dolby Atmos compatibility. In fact, let us conclude this Brave Browser first before we, you know, show you these suppliers, because again you might be a bit mixed up. Okay, so back to the Brave browser. In conclusion, the Brave browser is a fairly good browser which offers very good privacy protection. However, there are one or two things that you need to be aware of. First of all is the welcome tutorial, and it does appear as if that start page was actually a search engine, because it was in the search engine section. So again, you got to be a bit mindful about that, which again, the start page should be in a separate section. And the tutorial can be a little bit long-winded, and you've got the Brave rewards. And again, if you own a Fire tablet like this one, 8-inch, your device would not be eligible for Brave rewards. Video playback is not Dolby Atmos compatible, which again is a bit of a bad thing. Now on to the suppliers and back over to the UC browsers. And when I did the video test after filming the UC browser, which sort of went pear shaped, I was surprised to find out that it is Dolby Atmos compatible. So we're going to open UC browser. UC browser. And watch the same video again. And when this video loads, just give her a second. Right.
YouTube.
Now she is a bit slow loading, but that's probably because I've got my screen recorder running in the background. But what I might have to do is I might have to cut the video to save you waiting. Right, we'll be back with you.
Home, voice search. Brave rewards. Connected. Low power. Connected. Low power. Quick settings. Display brightness. Home button. Home. Mobizen. Dot. 13 minutes. Expand. Voice view. Expand. Edit button. Mo Brave Rewards. This is blue shade. Mobizen. Expand. Mobizen. Expand. Mo.
Alright then, sorry about the video cutting problem earlier, but the UC browser loading caused the device response to slow down a little bit, so again I do apologise for that. Now we've got the same video up again, and there is the speakers sound a bit better on this browser, like they did on the, unlike the Brave browser. So again, if you want to watch YouTube videos, then UC and UC Mini browsers are Dolby Atmos compatible, along with the Rocket browser, Fast browser, and the Opera Mini and Opera Mini Beta browsers. And there also is a Fast web browser app which is also compatible. So all those browsers so far are compatible with Dolby Atmos. Well, I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned and subscribe for more videos to come, and we will see you soon.